Today in Photoshop, we are going to be taking a look at how to adjust the spacing and other characteristics of your type. Now, working with type is key in almost all designs, so it is important to get a grasp on these tools. Now, keep in mind that though I am showing you these in Photoshop, they also exist in Illustrator, InDesign, Premiere, After Effects, and other Adobe software. So first go over and grab your text tool, and then drag out a text box and type something to work with. Make sure that you have at least two lines of text. Next, go up to Window, and then down to Character. Now, if you're working in a program that does not have a character option in this dropdown, such as Illustrator or InDesign, the character menu will be under Type. Now, once you have this open, you'll see a lot of different options. Now, you will likely already be familiar with changing the typeface, weight, and style. Now, you also have a number of options in the corner pull-down, as well as in the lower part of the panel for adjusting Fox, Bold, and Italic, All Caps, Small Caps, Super and Subscripts, Underline, and Strikethrough. Now, feel free to play with those on your own, as they are fairly self-explanatory. Now, above that, you're going to see options for scaling type vertically and horizontally. Now, I highly recommend that you don't use these, because distorting type should be a last resort to get the look that you want. It is much better to use the Leading, Kerning, and Tracking options towards the top of the panel. Leading controls how much space there are between the lines of your type, tracking controls how much space is between all of your letters, and kerning is used to change the distance between two specific letters. Now, if you forget what these mean, the icons next to the option do a pretty good job of representing them visually. Now, for my type, I will first start by selecting the word YouTube. Then we can go and make this bold by selecting it from the dropdown. Then after that, we can select the word RCG Tutorials and make that light. So after that, we can go ahead and scale up the word YouTube and scale down the word RCG Tutorials so that they each match in lengths. Now looking at this, we may want to increase the space between the letters of RCG Tutorials. Now to do this, select the word and then go ahead and scale up the tracking value. After that, go ahead and scale it back down so that it again matches the length of YouTube. Now since our text lines look like they're too separated, we may want to move the lines closer together. To do this, select all of the text and then lower the leading. Now if you still have spacing issues with certain letters, you can place the cursor between them and adjust the kerning to tweak the space. Now this isn't always necessary, but is an option if you do need to adjust it. You can now see by comparing it to our original text that we made a great improvement and we did it without distorting the type. As always, if you enjoyed this Photoshop tutorial, be sure to subscribe, rate, comment, and share it with your friends.